So, hello friends, welcome to my channel Nepin Coaching Center. So, today I'm going to explain you that is the directive principles of state policy, that is the fourth chapter of our social civics. In part 4 of our Indian Constitution, in Article 36 to 51, it consists of some of the directive principles of state policy, DPSP, and the aim of these principles is for ensuring socio-economic justice to the people and to establish welfare for Indian state. And the founding father of the Indian Constitution were aware of the fact that independent Indian states was going to face many challenges after colonial rule for almost 200 years, country and the society was left with widespread poverty, hunger, and with deep-rooted socio-economic inequalities. The framers of the Constitution, they felt that some of the certain policy directions, guidelines, or instructions for the governance of the country were required to handle these problems, and legislative and executive and administrative of the independent India were expected to exercise their powers in accordance with the direction and guidelines given in this part of the Constitution. So, directive principles of the state policy. Directive principles are some of the certain ideals, particularly aiming at socio-economic justice, which according to the framers of the Constitution, Indian state should strive for. The directive principles, that is as a normal feature of the Constitution, and they are in the nature of the general direction instructions, or they are like guidelines for the state. Directive principles embody the aspiration of the people and objectives and ideals which union and the state government must bear the mind while making the law. They should follow it while making the laws and formulating some of the policies. According to L.M. Singhvi, the directive principle are the life-giving provision of the Constitution. They represent the philosophy of social justice incorporated in the Constitution of India. Although directive principles are not justiciable or they are not legally binding by any courts, they are however fundamental in the governance of the country, and they lay down a code of conduct for the legislator, executive, administrator of the India so that they can discharge their responsibilities. In tune with these ideas, they can discharge their responsibilities. Next, philosophical base of the directive principles. Directive principles in the Indian Constitution are taken from the Constitution of Ireland, but the idea and philosophy of these principles can be traced back in French Declaration of Human Rights, American Declaration of Independence, liberal as well as socialist philosophy of 19th century, and our own Gandhian concept of Sarvodaya. Here also you can see these directive principles. So I hope Jennings, who has absorbed the philosophy underlying most of the directive principles, it is a Fabian socialism. Directive principles is Fabian socialism. Many of our constitution makers were under the great influence of socialism and Gandhism. So, though these provisions and principles, they laid down the socialist pattern of the society and Gandhian ideal state as the objective which the Indian state should strive to achieve. Article 37 of the Constitution states about the application of the directive principles, which says that the provision contained in the part Part 4 shall not be enforceable by any court, but principles therein laid down are nevertheless fundamental in the governance of the country, and it shall be duty of the state for applying that principles while making the laws. Next, classification of the directive principles of state policy. The directive principles, they are classified on the basis of their ideological source and objectives. For the sake of making the study convenient, we can broadly place them in four categories. They are the economic and social principle, directive based on Gandhian principle, directive principle relating to international peace, and miscellaneous. First one is the economic and social principle. It is a large number of directive principles that are socialist in nature and that has to dedicate to achieve for some social and economic welfare of the people by some of the objectives that are established in India as a welfare state. Some of the principles are: the state shall strive to promote welfare of the people by securing and protecting a social order in which justice, a social, economic and political shall inform all institutions of national life, in Article 38. Article 39 says that state shall in particular direct its policies towards securing rights to an adequate means of livelihood to all the citizens. The ownership and control of material resources shall be organized in a manner to serve the common good, and equal pay for equal work for both men and women. The strength and health of the worker. That the next is that the childhood and youth are not exploited. Article 42 declares that the state shall make provisions for securing justice and humane conditions of work and for materiality relief. Finally, according to the Article 43, the state shall endeavor to secure to all the workers a living wage and a decent standard of life, while Article 43A says that the state shall take steps to secure the participation of workers in the management of industry. Next, direct principles that are based on Gandhian principles. So Mahatma Gandhi was the main guiding force leading our freedom struggle. He had tremendous influence by the common people as well as framers of the constitution. These are certain directive principles that are aiming at implement as Gandhian principle. They are: state shall take steps to organize village panchayat as units of self-government in Article 40, and the state shall endeavor to promote cottage industry on an individual or cooperative basis in rural areas, Article 43. Article 45 provides for free and compulsory education to all children till the age of 14 years, and this original provision was amended by 86th Constitutional Amendment Act 2002, and it now declares that the state shall endeavor to promote early childhood care and education for all children until the complete of the age of 14 years in Article 21A. Next is Article 46, that it is known that the state shall promote education in common interest of the weaker section of the people, particularly that of the scheduled caste SCs and scheduled tribe SCs and other weaker sections. In Article 47, states that state shall have take some steps to improve the public health and prohibit consumption of intoxicating drinks and drugs that are injurious to health. Next, Article 48 says that the state shall take steps to prohibit slaughter of cows, calves and other milch and trot cattle. This was directive principles of Gandhian. Directive principle of Gandhi, where directives based on the Gandhian principle. Next, directive principles relating to international peace and security. After a year after the end of the Second World War, the Dutch made destroyed a huge destruction it has caused. So constitution making process began in India. After this, the constitution making process was began in India, and it was obvious that members of our constitution assembly were deeply concerned for the international peace and security. And through directive principles of state policy, they tried to ensure that the government of free India should render activity, cooperation, forward peace and security also. And Article 51 declares that to establish international peace and security, the state shall promote international peace and security. It should maintain justice and honorable relationship with the nation, foster respect for international law and treaty obligation, and encourage settlement of international disputes by arbitration. Finally, the last topic of this chapter. Salience directive principles. The fourth category of directive principle contains some of the general subject which are sometimes termed as liberal principles. They are in the Article 44. The state shall endeavor to issue a secure for the citizens a uniform civil code through the territory of India. Article 48A directs the state to protect and improve the environment and thus to safeguard the forest and wildlife of the country. Article 49, state should protect every monument or place of artistic or historic interest. And Article 50, the state shall take steps to separate judiciary from the executive in the public service of the state. So, okay friends, this was your chapter, directive principle, state of state policy. So I think you understand this chapter. So okay friends, like the video, comment on my video and subscribe my channel MN Coaching Center for more video. I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care, have a nice day, bye my dear friends.